dear children, we once again welcome you to our Sunday service this morning. And before we can start our Sunday service, let us put our hands together, dear children. Close our eyes, bow our heads, and pray. Thank you, God, for giving us this day to hear your word once again. We thank you for the gift of this morning. We thank you that you have been gracious to us to give us this week. How we pray, O God, that this service will be a blessing in our lives and will help us to be the children that you desire us to be. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. I hope you have said an amen, dear children. Now, dear children, I want us, before we start our service, I hope you have your notebook, your pen, and now you're seated very quietly waiting to listen to from God. Now, before we start our lesson today, I want us to sing one song that I know we know, all of us. We have been singing it for a while now, so that we can start our service. So this is how our song goes. What can wash away my sin? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. What can make me whole again? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. Oh, precious is the flow that makes me white as snow. No other fount I know. Nothing but the blood of Jesus. Now, are you ready, dear children? We can sing it one more time. Is that okay? Okay, are you now ready? One, two, go. What can wash away my sin? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. What can make me whole again? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. Oh, precious is the flow that makes me white as snow. No other fount I know. Nothing but the blood of Jesus. Indeed, nothing can wash us our sins and make us whole again unless it is the blood of Jesus Christ. Now, dear children, let me ask you. The day you were born, what do you call it? Aha! Yes, it is called a birthday. And I know that day, mommy prepares a cake for you or buys a cake for you and some few snacks, and they sing a happy birthday song for you. That is what our mothers and our daddies do. But let me tell you, dear children, do you know God is also happy when we have our second birth? That is what we are going to learn from God's word today. And God's word is written in the Bible. The Bible is the true word of God, and everything that is said in the Bible is true because God inspired the people who wrote the Bible and he told them what to write. Our Bible is divided into two parts, the Old Testament and the New Testament. The Old Testament are the things that happened before Christ, and the New Testament things that happened during the time of Christ and even after Christ had gone to be in heaven. So our memory verse today comes from the book of John. John is found in the New Testament, John chapter 3 and verse 3. And this is what my Bible says. I tell you the truth, no one can see the kingdom of God unless he is born again. Maybe your version says differently, and another version too. And because I want us to learn the memory verse, all of us together, what I have done, dear children, is that I have written the memory verse in a flash card. So this is our memory verse. So can we say the memory verse together, dear children? John 3:3. Unless one is born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God. John 3:3. So what is the Bible telling us by saying, unless one is born again? The Bible says, before you were a very good person, you were holy, you had a relationship with Jesus Christ. But when sin came, sin separated you from God. And now you had become a sinner. God wants you once again to accept him as our Lord and Savior, so that he comes and dwells in your heart. And only then, when you have your second birthday, that means you can now see the kingdom of God. Where is the kingdom of God, dear children? The kingdom of God is in heaven. And the Bible says heaven is a place made of gold, a streets of gold. And no one can go to heaven unless he has been born again, because sin can never be in heaven. Heaven is a perfect place where God lives. And God wants us to live with him in heaven someday. That's why he says, unless we ask Jesus to wash away our sins, make us clean, then we cannot see the kingdom of God. So, dear children, if you are here and you have believed in the Lord Jesus Christ, God wants you to tell him thank you, because he came and paid the price for your sins so that you can be washed of your sins, like our song has said, and made clean through Christ Jesus. Then you can see the kingdom of God. But if you have never believed in the Lord Jesus Christ, the Bible is saying you will never have the privilege, the opportunity to see the kingdom of God unless you are born again. I know children are asking, do I go back to my mother's womb and be born again? No. It's to tell God, I am sorry for the sins that I have done. And then he comes into your heart and lives there. And when he lives, sin goes away. And each and every time you find yourself sinning again, you can tell God you're sorry, and God will have a fellowship with you. And when he has fellowship with you, then you can be able to see the kingdom of God. Now, dear children, I want us to memorize the memory verse. So are you ready, dear children? We are going to use what is called crazy stand up. And crazy stand up is that if I mention a color and you see it around your house, or you have it in your cloth or your dress or your trouser or your shirt, then you will stand and say the memory verse. So, but before we do that, all of us, we are going to say the memory verse. Now, if you know you have black hair, can you stand and say the memory verse? John 3:3. Unless one is born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God. John 3:3. Very good, dear children. If you have anything that is blue, can you stand and say the memory verse? 1, 2, go. John 3:3. Unless one is born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God. John 3:3. If you have anything that is red, can you stand and say the memory verse? John 3:3. Unless one is born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God. John 3:3. If you have blue dress or flower, anything that is blue around you, can you stand and say the memory verse? John 3:3. Unless one is born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God. John 3:3. Now, dear children, we have learned the memory verse. And the Bible says that unless we are born again, we can never see the kingdom of God. Now, if you are here and you have never believed in the Lord Jesus Christ, and you wish to believe in the Lord Jesus Christ so that you can have your second birth, would you show me by raising up your hand? Yes. I have not seen those hands, but God in heaven has seen these hands and has seen your desire to believe in Him. Maybe you are there and you have not been doing right things. You have been taking people's things without their permission. Or you have been running away when your mommy says stay at home. You have been disobedient and running away outside to go and play with your friends. That is being disobedient. And God wants you to accept Him as your Lord and Savior so that He will come and dwell in your heart so that you will have or you will have an opportunity to live with Him in His kingdom in heaven. So if you raised up your hand and you want to believe in the Lord Jesus Christ, would you please stand up? Okay, we are going to say a prayer with you. So we'll put our hands together, close our eyes, bow our heads, and pray. Say this prayer after me. Dear Lord, I know I am a sinner. I have done things that make you sad. Forgive me and make me your child. In Jesus' name, amen. If you said that prayer with me, you have now become a new person. God wants you to believe in Him. And I want you to start reading the Bible. The best book to start reading from is the book of Luke. Luke chapter 1. So each and every time, you can take the book of Luke, your Bible, the book of Luke, and start reading it. If you're 5 years, you can read 5 verses each and every day and ask God to help you understand what you are reading. Now, God has reminded us today that there's only one way that we can be able to reach the kingdom of God, one way to reach heaven. And we have a song that talks about that, dear children. And I know you also love it so much. It's called One Way. It gives you direction to what God wants of you and how you can be able to reach the kingdom of God. So this is how the song goes. I know you know it, dear children, so I will sing it one more time and then you will sing it after me. Is that okay, dear children? Okay. So this is how it goes. One way God said to get to heaven, Jesus is the only way. One way to reach those pearly mansions, Jesus is the only way. No other way, no other way, no other way to go. One way God said to get to heaven, Jesus is the only way. We can sing it now together, dear children. Are you there? Hey. So I want us to sing the song once again together. So one to go. One way God said to get to heaven, Jesus is the only way. One way to reach those pearly mansions, Jesus is the only way. No other way, no other way, no other way to go. One way God said to get to heaven, Jesus is the only way. Indeed, Jesus is the only way that we can use to go to heaven. And now, dear children, we have come to the end of our service, and I want us to pray. So let us pray. Put our hands together, close our eyes, bow our heads, and pray. Dear Lord, we thank you for reminding us that for us to get to heaven, we need to accept you as our Lord and Savior. Thank you for this word that has come forth to us this day. May it be useful in our hearts and even in our lives. For those who have accepted you as their Lord and Savior, Lord, I pray that you'll send your Holy Spirit to them so that they will, Holy Spirit will walk with them, guide their every footstep, even as they desire to work for you and to walk in your ways. We ask this, trusting and believing in Jesus' name. Amen. We have come to the end of our Sunday school lesson this Sunday, dear children. And we want to thank you for all those who have been following us online each and every Sunday. But the surprise that I have for you, these children, this Sunday, is that next week on Sunday, we will all be in church. And now we welcome you, dear children, to our Sunday services that will be conducted in our service. Welcome back to church for those who will be coming on in church. And those who will not be coming, we will still have our virtual lessons going on until normalcy returns. So dear children, next week on Sunday, I will be happy to see you in the service. May the Lord bless you and protect you even as you prepare to come. See you next Sunday in church. Bye.